Tremors from the killer Wayanad landslide can still be felt today. If we speak about the number of people who have died, the number stands at close to 380. Thousands of rescuers at the moment are still hard at work. Families of those who are still missing, they have some hope left because the rescue operation is still not complete. The rescue operation, in fact, has now entered day 7. Thousands of affected people have already been rescued and they are currently living in relief camps. Amid all this, there's a burial ground that has been prepared to bury the body of the unidentified victims.
A burial ground is being prepared here at Puttumala in Wayanad to bury the victims, the unidentified victims of the landslide here. As you can see here, preparations underway here at Puttumala for this mass burial that's going to take place. In fact, there's been a standard operating procedure that's been issued by the state government, the guidelines that needs to be followed. They did keep the mortal remains for a while at the hospital, but since nobody came forward to receive the mortal remains, as well as there have been many bodies that was recovered in an unidentifiable condition. So all of those will be buried here is what we're understanding. It's not just the authorities, but the locals, everybody coming here, the political parties coming here, taking over this ceremony, ensuring that at least the last rites is being performed well for these people. So it's an extremely heartbreaking scene. A death that nobody deserves, where your body is not being identified, where people does not recognize you. So extremely heartbreaking scenes. That's what we've been seeing in Wayanad since the last 1 week, since this landslide took place here. But this definitely is the most heart-wrenching sight that we've seen after coming here. With video journalist Tinku Rajshekar, Shibi Mulkeji for India Today from Wayanad.
Most of the times when we see a vehicle carrying relief items to landslide hit Wayanad, it usually has a banner, and that banner says Wayanad in Uru Kaitang, which essentially translates to a helping hand for Wayanad. But from the ground, what is very, very evident is that it's not just a helping hand, but it's rather thousands or even perhaps lakhs of helping hands. We're currently reporting from the St. Joseph's Convent School in Kalpatta, Wayanad, which is the main collection point for relief items that are coming in from different parts of the country. Anyone who's donating relief items to the survivors of the landslide, the floods in Wayanad, all that relief items come here through the Wayanad District Collectorate. It is stored here, segregated, and then of course taken to the relief camps where this is much needed, where these materials are much needed. There are of course at least 90 relief camps in Wayanad where over 10,000 people are currently staying. And this, I think, is the perfect example to show how the entire country, they very well realize that people of Wayanad are going through one of the most difficult times of their lives. And that's the reason why the entire country is standing in solidarity, giving them the much needed support, and also realizing that this is the time that they need empathy, compassion, and whatever little support. And that's the reason why we see this outpouring of support here in Kalpatta, Wayanad. With video journalist Daniel, this is Shilpa Nair for India Today.
My colleague Shibi Mulkeji is now joining me from the same spot where at the moment a burial ground is being prepared. Shibimol, we understand the rescue work is still going on, and at the moment the idea is to make sure that all the unidentified bodies are buried with all the rituals that need to be done.
Ashira, yes, that's been the priority. But right now I'm actually at Churulmala, the landslide site where the rescue operation is still going on. The burial ground is very close by from here. It's at Puttumala, where again a landslide had taken place a few years ago. So around 5 people are still missing in that landslide. It was not a landslide of this magnitude that took place here in Churulmala and Mundakai, but it was also a landslide where 5 people have gone missing. So they have made this burial ground in the exact location where this landslide took place. This is also probably going to be that, after a few days, the number of people missing, once they have a data from the local self-government, those missing people will also be, calculated as missing cases. It would go on to the police register as missing cases. That's what usually happens. So in the past, that's what we've seen. So this is also probably going to be that, considering that there are more than 250 people missing and there are around 400 missing complaints that, the district administration has received. That is also because there are many bodies which are still in unidentifiable condition. So the official state data still shows that it's around 250 people who are still missing. But the complaints that the district administration has received as of now is around 400. So it's still many people missing that under debris, because when we went up to Mundakai where the landslide struck, the entire two lane of has been washed away, which means the houses in that area has been washed. When we spoke to the locals, they were saying that there are many houses in that line. The official numbers could not be true at all, considering what the locals are saying. There are many people, but the challenge here in identifying those people, even the missing cases, that it's the ASHA workers, the Kudumbashri workers, who know these people in and out the area, in and out, but unfortunately all of them have also gone missing. So that's the main challenge ahead for the district administration, especially the health department, in having a data regarding the missing as well as the death cases.
Thank you, Shibi Mol, for giving us all those details. Now, India Today's Akshita Nandgopal has been on the ground covering the ongoing rescue operations in Wayanad. The death toll from multiple landslides unfortunately at the moment stands at 370. The rescue teams are working to reach all the areas possible. In fact, families in close-by towns are awaiting news of their loved ones. Hopes at the moment are diminishing to find the survivors. We are leaving you with Akshita Nandgopal's ground report.
What you see on your screens is the first point of Mundakai that was hit by these landslides at 1 a.m. in the morning. We've trekked all the way to the end of Mundakai town, where authorities, rescue officials have been able to reach just a few days ago. So operations here began just 2 days ago, so the hunt continues for any bodies. Now, this entire stretch, you can see the amount of debris that's left behind where I'm standing, and the entire area around here, they were actually homes, including homestay. So this was a very popular tourist destination, all completely wiped out. And you can see that there's absolutely no trace of any house anywhere around me, which is why officials fear right now that the bodies could have been washed far, far away. There is a smell in the air of decaying bodies, which is why officials continue to dig through this entire area, looking for any remnants of mortal remains. We've now trekked right down to Churalmara, and it's from here essentially that you get access to Mundakai. This area was completely cut off, and that was the biggest challenge, because the river had in fact occupied all of the space. The river wasn't spayed very clearly, and that's what made it all the more difficult for officials to reach over to the other side. Now, so many days on since the landslides have taken place, it's because of the army's deployment that now Mundakai has become accessible. This entire area now, there's work afoot to ensure that the debris is cleared and also to find all of the bodies that are currently lying in these areas. It's been pushed from the beginning, from where I was in Mundakai to all the way here in Churalmara and beyond as well. Till much beyond, almost 10-15 kilometers away, is where bodies and body parts are being found, which is why this rescue operation is going to continue for days on end. It's going to take a lot more time. In Wayanad, of course, all resources are put up right here. It's at this spot that you have every single setup being made, and from here that all the equipment, the vehicles make their way. This bridge has been the game changer. The Bailey Bridge, constructed by the army in record time, has ensured that officials are able to make their way right now to Mundakai and beyond. And it's this accessibility that's been a game changer in relief operations, which we track very closely here on India Today. With video journalist Sachin Chandok, this is Akshita Nandgopal reporting from landslide hit Wayanad for India Today.